Happy New Year! Hello, lovelies, and welcome to another one of my videos in which we'll be talking about 6 ideas for fertility resolutions for 2020. First of all, I want to wish you a really happy new year. I want to wish you all the best for your health, for your friendships, your relationships with your family. And of course, I hope the very best for you fertility-wise. And I've got someone else that wants to say happy new year to you. Where'd you go? Didi, where'd you go? Happy new year! She's gonna be hanging out with me in this video. A good old time. But now, of course, let's get into those 6 resolutions. The first idea is to plan to focus on something else besides your fertility. Yes, of course, you're going to have normal life, cleaning your house, maybe you have a job, you have your friendship, your relationships that you need to take care of, but resolve to focus on one special project, one special thing for 2020 so that you don't go crazy over trying to fall pregnant, because that can be such a vortex online, researching stuff, waiting to take your temperature in the morning, waiting to take a pregnancy test, waiting to take an ovulation test. You need something to take your mind off that. And not only that, life is more than fertility. Yes, believe it or not, I know we sometimes forget about that when we are dealing with fertility issues, when we're trying to get pregnant. So obviously there are loads of things that you can focus on. Perhaps you have been a bit of a hoarder and maybe you want to use 2020 to really get rid of all the clutter in your house. Now that might be a bit of an obvious project, but perhaps you've wanted to read lots of classics from your reading list in high school. Maybe that's something you want to tackle. Or perhaps there's a hobby that you used to do but you haven't made time for anymore. Maybe you like to quilt. Maybe you've got some lovely fabrics waiting for you. Maybe you have played the piano in the past or another instrument. Why don't you pick that back up? The cool thing about doing something like this is that it gives you another thing to research, another thing to fill your Pinterest boards with, another thing to look up YouTube videos for, another thing to read blogs on, and not just have the fertility stuff. So a great New Year's resolution is to pick up another project or hobby for this year. If you're new to my channel, you may not have heard this from me yet, but hey, I need to include this one. If you already have seen loads of videos from me, you will know what this is. Chart your cycle. And no, it's not just to find your fertile window so that you can make love at the right time, right before the egg drops. No, it's also so that you can understand your hormonal health, that you have a better understanding of your cycle, generally speaking, that you discover patterns, that you find out if there are certain hormones that are on the low side or are more dominant. This is valuable information. This says something about your health. So resolve to start charting your cycle and just do it. No excuses. I will forget to take my temperature. I haven't got the right cool thermometer or ovulation test strips or the right app. All that information is on this channel. There is no reason for you not to get started with 3 simple steps. I will include some videos to point you in that direction. Now, the next idea for a resolution might not be very popular, so you don't have to resolve to do this, but I highly recommend it. And that is not just don't give up about falling pregnant naturally, but also don't whine about it. Yes, I do want you to grieve. Of course it's hard if you keep getting your period every month, if you have had pregnancy losses. You need to grieve over this. There is no good reason to stuff those emotions. They will only make you sick and bitter. However, whining does not help you or your environment. So resolve to make your personal space a no whining zone. And one of those things that you may want to include is avoid certain fertility communities, because I have seen that whining is encouraged a lot. People posting up whiny posts about getting another negative test and then people supporting that. That is not going to help you, I promise. The more positive you're able to be about this journey, without ignoring the grief. That's important. I'm not telling you not to grieve and just be positive, because that doesn't work either. But be positive and grieve about the real stuff, but don't whine. That's going to get you so much further. And not only that, it will make you a nicer person to be around. And when you do fall pregnant, you will actually have people around you that will be super happy for you. If you're whining right now about not falling pregnant, it's gonna be a habit. And when you do fall pregnant, you're going to whine about other stuff. So the no whining zone is really something that is going to benefit you for the rest of your life and the people around you. A resolution that kind of fits in with the previous one is that you resolve to be happy for people that do fall pregnant and people that do have children. You are going to continue to be confronted with pregnancy announcements, with big bellies, and it's not going to benefit you if you're going to try to avoid that all the time. Of course, there's a good reason for you not to go a certain route home and not pass that cute baby shop. You're allowed to do that. You don't have to go to every baby shower, especially of people that you don't really know. But it's not going to help you if you're going to continue to avoid everything that has to do with pregnancy or babies. Rather, in my experience, when I didn't have a baby, when I was really sad, when I was living in a part of London that seemed to attract all the pregnant couples for some reason, what really helped me was to actually connect with the people that were pregnant and were having babies. When you stick around for the pregnancies of your friends and people around you, that probably means you get to hold their baby when the baby arrives. And you know how healing those baby cuddles and baby laughs can be. You not having a baby in your womb or your arm right now doesn't mean that you cannot enjoy other people's babies. So I would really recommend for you to resolve to be happy for people that fall pregnant and people that have babies. Again, this is going to make you a much nicer person to be around, but you are going to feel so much better yourself. You're actually going to enjoy a lot more being around yourself, probably. And again, I'm not discarding the fact that you grieve. When you resolve something like this, your heart will follow. Initially, you may feel really crappy about it and feel like, I decided to be happy for somebody, but it's up here and not here. Eventually, it will sink in. It will become a habit and it will become like a second nature to you. I promise. Just stick with it. Resolution number 5 is that you take care of your health for you and not just because you want to fall pregnant. You know what? You deserve to invest in your health for you. Not just because you want to conceive and because you want to have a baby. If you invest in your health, you're going to feel so much happier emotionally. You're going to be so much more able physically to do the things that you want. If you're feeling blue about not having that baby and not being pregnant, it's not going to help you if you're also overweight, if you're hanging on the couch, not doing anything, and if you're lacking lots of nutrients, because there are lots of chemical processes in your body that can actually make you feel low. For example, having low magnesium is going to make you nervous and panic easier. If you have low vitamin D, you're prone to being depressed. Also the same for low fatty acids. And even just not drinking enough water can make you feel clouded in your head. So you really deserve to invest in your health just for you and not for just a pregnancy. If you do this, that means you will also stick with it whenever you have a negative pregnancy test or that ovulation test is not showing up or you're having a fight with your spouse over falling pregnant or anything else. Usually these are the moments that you would give up on investing in your health because that pregnancy feels so far away. What's the point? However, if you're investing in your health for you, you will still be able to keep up with those healthy habits. And resolution number 6 is that you make lovemaking enjoyable in the first place and a tool to fall pregnant in the second place. If you switch those two around, that is not going to benefit your relationship. It's not going to benefit you. If you've been trying to conceive for any length of time, you probably already know this. So I just wanted to mention this, that this can be something that you resolve and that you resolve together with your partner. Because I know that some partners will stop initiating because they only wait for the fertile window to come around. However, if you make it a priority that it is something that you do together to build your relationship and that feels good for both of you, then your partner will hopefully initiate that as well, and it will become less about the baby making and it will become more about building your relationship and something that you enjoy together. I think the first step to this resolution is that we all stop calling it baby making. All right, my lovelies, I hope that you found some inspiration in these resolutions to make you positive and excited about the new year, as well as about your fertility and whatever lies ahead for you. Whatever you do with these resolutions or any other resolutions, keep it simple, keep it small, because that will get you to your goal. If you'd like to see more videos on how to boost your fertility naturally, make sure to click on the playlist on your screen right now. And if you want to see more videos in the future, make sure to subscribe because I bring out new videos every Thursday. And in the meantime, see you in the next video. Bye.